Hello, this is Product Filter in PHP with Pagination tutorial series, and under this part, we will learn how to fetch product data from data and display on web page with pagination by using PHP script with vanilla JavaScript. Under this tutorial series, we have used pure vanilla JavaScript instead of jQuery library, and by using JavaScript, we will mark the product filter with pagination feature. Now let's start discussing this topic. So this is our test database, and under this, we have one same data table, and under this table, we have already inserted more than 12,000 plus records. So we will use this table for build product filter with pagination. This is our index.html page. Under this page, we have already included Bootstrap library. Under this page, first we have create one division tag with class as equal to row. Under this tag we have create two division tag. In first division tag, we have write class as equal to column small 3, padding 3 and background light class of Bootstrap 5 library. In second division tag, we have write class as equal to column small 9 class. So here we have divide page in two division tag. In first division tag, we will make different product filter. And in second division tag, we will list product with pagination link. Now in second division tag, for display product, here we have create one division tag with it as equal to product area. Under this tag, we will display product. And for display pagination link, we have create one more division tag with it as equal to pagination area, and class as equal to margin top 2 and margin bottom 5 class of Bootstrap library. So here our HTML skeleton is readly for display product on web page. Now we want to write JavaScript code for fetch data from MySQL database and display on web page. For this we have go to JavaScript code area, and here we have create function with dollar sign, and in argument we have write selector. Under this function, we have write return statement with document.querySelector method, and under this, we have write selector variable. Below this, we have create one more JavaScript function with name load product with argument like page is equal to 1. Under this function, we have write JavaScript fetch API, and under this, we have write process.php question mark page is equal to page variable, so it will send get request to this PHP file. After this, we have write dot then method, and under this, we have write callback function with response as argument. Under this function, we have write return statement with response.json method. Then after, we have again write then method, and then again we have write callback function with response data variable as argument. So this function will receive data from server in JSON format. Under this function, we have write HTML variable is equal to blank value. Below this, we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write response data dot data. If this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. Under this block, we have again write if statement, and under condition, we have write response data dot data dot length value is greater than 0. Suppose this condition false, then it will execute else block of code. Under this block, we have write dollar function with division tag id product area with inner HTML is equal to message like no product found. But suppose above condition true, then it will execute if block of code, and under this, we have write HTML variable. Here we have append HTML code like paragraph tag with class is equal to H6. And between this, we have write response data dot total data variable value product found, so it will display total number of product details on web page. Below this, we have write HTML variable, and here we have append HTML code like division tag with class is equal to row class. After this, we have write for loop, and under condition, we have write variable I is equal to 2, I variable value is less than the value of response data dot data length, and I variable value increment by 1. Under this loop, we have HTML variable, and here we have append HTML data like division tag with class is equal to column medium 3, margin bottom 2, and padding 3 class. After this, we have HTML variable, and here we have append HTML code like image tag with source is equal to response data dot data variable with iindex.image, so it will display product image. Here we have also write class is equal to image fluid, border, margin bottom 3 and padding 3 class. Next we have write HTML variable, and here we have append HTML code like paragraph tag, and between this, we have write response data dot data variable with iindex.name, so it will display product name details on web page. After this, we want to display product brand details, so here we have write HTML variable, and here we have append HTML code like span tag with class is equal to badge, background info and text dark class, and between this, we have write response data dot data iindex dot brand, so it will display product brand details. Same way for display product price details, here we have write HTML variable, and here we have append HTML code like span tag, and between this, first we want to display currency symbol, so we have write open and close span tag, and between this, we have write this code, so it will display rupee symbol. Next, for display product price, we have write response data dot data with index I dot price, so it will display product price on web page. So here, we have store all HTML data under this HTML variable. Now for display under product area division tag, so for this, here we have write dollar function with division tag it product area dot inner HTML is equal to HTML variable, so it will display product on web page. After this for display pagination link, here we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write response data dot pagination, if this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. Under this block, we have write dollar function, with division tag it pagination area, dot inner HTML is equal to response data dot pagination, so it will display pagination link on web page. Now want to call this function, so here we have write load product function, so when page has been load then this function will be called, and it will display product data on web page with pagination link. So here our JavaScript code is ready. Now we have go to process.php file, and here first we want to make database connection, so for this here we have write $connect variable is equal to new PDO class object with 3 argument. In first argument, we have write MySQL host is equal to localhost, and database name is equal to test. In second argument, user set to root, and in third argument, password set to blank. So it will make database connection. After this, we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write is set function, and under this, we have write $getPage variable. If this variable value is set, then it will execute if block of code. Under this block, we have write $data variable is equal to array. Below this, we have to write a $limit variable is equal to 8, so it will display 8 products on the web page, and to view other product, we have to click on next page pagination link. After this, we have write $page is equal to 1, in this variable, we will store value of page number. Below this, we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write $getPage variable value is greater than 1. If this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. Under this block, we have to write the $start variable is equal to $getPage variable value minus 1 into $limit variable value. It will calculate the row number from which data has been started for fetch from the database. After this, we have write $page variable is equal to value of $getPage variable. But suppose the above condition is false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write the $start variable value is equal to 0. Now we have go to select query for fetch data from database. For this here we have write $query variable is equal to select name, price, images, brand from sample data table, order by sample id in ascending order. So below this query, we have to write the $filter query variable is equal to $query variable, and after this we have appended a query like limit with $start variable value, comma $limit variable value, so this query will fetch only some data from the database. Below this, we have write $statement is equal to $connect variable with prepare statement, and under this, we have write $query variable. It will prepare query for execution. Next, we want to execute query. So here we have write $statement variable with execute method. It will execute above select query. After query execution, now first we want to get total number of product data. So for this, here we have to write the $total data variable is equal to $statement variable with the row count method. This method will return the number of rows affected by last query execution. Next we want to execute query with data limit. So for this, we have to write a $result variable is equal to $connect variable with fetch method, and under this, we have write $filter query variable. So it will execute query and return query execution result. Now for fetch data from $result variable, we have write foreach loop, and under condition, we have write $result variable as $row variable. Under this loop, we have write $ImageArray variable is equal to explode function with two argument. In first argument, we have write tilde sign, and in second argument, we have write $rowImages variable. So this code will convert image string into array. Below this, we have write $data variable is equal to array. In first key, we have name, and in value, we have write $rowName variable. In second key, we have write price, and in value, we have write $rowPrice variable. In third key, we have right brand, and in value, we have right dollar row brand variable. And in last key, we have right image, and in value, we have right dollar image array variable with zero index, so on every loop, it will store product data in dollar data variable. Next we have to make pagination link, so here we have write dollar pagination html variable is equal to this html code, so here we have use bootstrap 5 library pagination class. Now we have to write $TotalLinks variable is equal to seal function, and under this, we have to write $TotalData variable is divided by the $Limit variable value. It will calculate the total number of pagination links. After this, we have to write $PreviousLink variable is equal to the blank value. Under this variable, we will store the previous page pagination link. Same way for store next page pagination link, here we have to write $NextLink variable is equal to blank value. And for store page number pagination links, here we have to write $PageLink variable is equal to the blank value. Now first we want to make a page number array, so from that array, we can directly make pagination link with previous and next page link also. For these things, we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write $TotalLinks variable value is greater than 4. If this condition false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write for loop, and under condition. We have to write $count variable value is equal to 1, $count variable value is less than or equal to value of $TotalLinks variable, and $count variable value is incremented by 1. Under this loop, we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to the $count variable, so on every interval, it will store page number under this $PageArray variable in array format. But suppose the $TotalLinks variable value is greater than 4, then it will execute if block of code. And under this block, we have again write if statement, and under condition, we have write $page variable value is less than 5. If this condition true, then it will execute this if block of code. Under this block, we have to write $count variable value is equal to 1, $count variable value is less than equal to 5, and $count variable value is incremented by 1. Under this loop, we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to the $count variable value, so on every interval, it will store page number under this $PageArray variable in array format. After storing number up to 5 numbers, now we want to store blank data in this array. So for this, we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to 3 dot. And lastly, in this array, we want to store the last page number. So for this, we have to write the $PageArray variable is equal to $TotalLinks variable value. But suppose, if the $page variable value is greater than 5, then it will execute else block of code. And under this block, we have write $endLimit variable is equal to $TotalLinks variable value minus 5. Below this, we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write $page variable value is greater than the value of $endLimit variable value. If this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. Under this block, first we have to write the $PageArray variable is equal to 1 number, so here we have a store page number in the array. After this, we want to store blank data with 3 dots, so here again we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to 3 dot. And for store the last 5 page number, we have to write $count variable value is equal to value of $end limit variable value. After this, $count variable value is less than or equal to value of $total links variable value, and $count variable value is incremented by 1. Under this loop, we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to the $count variable, so on every interval, it will store page number under this $PageArray variable in array format. But suppose the above condition is false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this, first we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to one number, so here we have store page number in the array. After this, we want to store blank data with 3 dots, so here again we have to write the $PageArray variable is equal to 3 dots. And for store middle page numbers, here we have to write $count variable value is equal to the value of $page variable minus 1, and $count variable value is less than or equal to value of $page variable plus 1, and $count variable value is incremented by 1. Under this loop, we have write $PageArray variable is equal to $count variable, so on every interval, it will store page number for make middle page number pagination link. After this, we want to again store blank number with 3 dots, so here also, we have write $PageArray variable is equal to 3 dots. And lastly, we want to store the last page number, so here we have to write $PageArray variable is equal to $total links variable value. Now for make a pagination link, here we have to write for loop, and under condition, we have to write $count variable value is equal to 0, $count variable value is less than the value of count function with $PageArray variable, and count variable value is incremented by 1. Under this loop, we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write $page variable value is equal to value of $page array with $count variable value as index. If this condition is true, then it will execute if block of code, and here we have write a $page link variable, and here we have appended this HTML code. It will make a pagination link for the active page. And here, for display page number, we have to write a $page array with $count variable value as index. Under this if block, we have to make previous page pagination link, and the next page pagination link. For this, here we have write the $previous id variable value is equal to $page array with $count variable value, minus 1. From this code, it will make the previous page number. Below this, we have to write if statement and under condition, we have write $previous id variable value is greater than 0. If the condition is true, then it will make the previous page clickable link. And under this block, we have to write $previous link variable is equal to list tag with class is equal to page item, and in anchor tag, we have write class is equal to page link. After this class, we have write href attribute is equal to JavaScript double colon load product function, and in argument, we have write previous id variable value. So when we have click on this pagination link, then it will called load product function. But suppose the above condition is false, then it will execute else block, and here, we have write the dollar previous link variable is equal to, this HTML code, it will make disable previous page link. Same way for make the next page pagination link, here we have to write, $next id variable is equal to, $pageArray, with $count variable value plus 1, this code will create next page number. Now we have write if statement, and under condition, we have write $next id variable value is greater than or equal to, value of $total links variable value, suppose this condition true. Then it will execute if block of code, and here we have to write $next link variable is equal to, this HTML code, so here it will make disable next page pagination link. But suppose the above condition is false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $next link variable is equal to, list tag with class is equal to page item. Under this, we have to write, anchor tag, with class is equal to page link, and after this, we have write anchor tag, with href attribute is equal to, javascript with double colon, and after this, we have write load product function with $next id variable, as argument. So it will make next page pagination link. Now suppose, this condition false, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have write, if statement and under condition, we have write $pageArray variable, with $count variable value is equal to, 3 dot. If this condition is true, then it will execute if block of code, and here we have write $page link variable, and here we have appended this HTML code, it will disable pagination links. But suppose the above condition is false, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have write a $page link variable, and here we have appended HTML code like, list tag with class is equal to page item. Under this list tag, we have write anchor tag, with class is equal to page link, and after this, we have write href attribute is equal to, javascript with double colon, and load product function, $pageArray with $count variable as index. So when user have click on this pagination link, then it will call load product javascript function, and it will load that page product on web page, without refresh of web page. So, here we have store, previous page link in $previous link variable, page number link in $page link variable, and next page link in $next link variable. Now we want to combine it, so here we have to write a $pagination HTML variable, and here we have appended data, like $previous link variable value, $page link variable value, and $next link variable value. So, here we have store pagination link data, under this $pagination HTML variable, now we want to send data to fetch a pajax request, so here we have to write $output variable is equal to array. In the first key, we have write data, and in value we have write $data variable. In the second key, we have write pagination, and in value, we have write $pagination HTML variable. And in the last key, we have write total data, and in value, we have write $total data variable, so here we have store data in $output variable. Now we want to send this data to AJAX request in JSON format, so here we have to write an echo statement with a JSON encode function, and under this, we have to write $output variable, so this data will be displayed on a web page. So here our code is ready, now we have to check output in the browser. Friends, here we can see that when page has been loaded in browser, then here on web page, we can see that 8 product has been displayed on web page, and above this, we can see that this 8 product has been displayed from more than 12,000 product. So by using pagination, it has not load all product from database, but it has load only 8 product from database when page has been load. So it has reduced load on server and database. Below this list of product, we can see pagination link with previous and next page link, and by using this pagination link, we can view other page product on web page. Now we want to check if the pagination link is working or not. So first we have to click on any pagination link, and after clicking on the link, we can see that page product has been loaded on the web page without refresh of web page. So here our pagination link has been working properly. So friends, in this video tutorial, we have learned how list product on web page with pagination by using PHP script with vanilla JavaScript. In next part, we will learn how add skeleton loader before loading of product on web page using JavaScript and Bootstrap 5 library.